Hello and welcome to the Django DRF project, eCommerce. This tutorial is part of a series of tutorials which you can watch for free. The link to the YouTube course playlist is in the video description. This course is also available on Udemy, where you can watch the course ad-free, download the tutorial source code, and access all updated tutorials and playlist. The link to the course, which will always provide the best price, can be found in the video description. Having now implemented a basic category endpoint, let's do the same thing now with brand, and then we do the same thing with product. So my aim at this point is just to get all the groundwork done for all the tables. Once we've done that, we can then start to think about more specifics, more queries that we're actually going to need to develop, and that will help us mold and build and make changes to our serializers and to our views. So let's jump back into the project. Let's just drop that down. Let's get rid of everything. We'll start fresh. Right. So we're going to implement the brand. So we're going to need a serializer, then a view, and then we sort out the routers. So that's the process. Same as what we did previously with the category. So we'll start off. I think we've actually done the serializer already. We've built it already. So in serializers, yeah, we've already built the serializer. This is the brand serializer. So that's already for us to utilize. So let's go into the view. So we're just going to implement this in a really simplistic way to begin with, like we did with category, so that we can just access all the brands from the brand table. So what we can probably do here is just copy that down. Let's call that the brand view set. So this is apologies, I'm skipping around here. Oh, I keep pressing the wrong button. How is it that I keep forgetting that? So just drop that down. Right, so the brand, a simple view set for viewing all brands. So the query set now is brand.objects.all. It looks like we haven't included it in, so let's just go to the top here, just make sure that we add the brand and also the product. We're going to need that later. Saves us a bit of time. Right, so that just makes the model available. Right, so we've run our query set, brand.objects.all, so we're just going to collect all brands. That's what we're going to do at the moment. So we're going to use the brand serializer. That's the plan. So it doesn't look like we've incorporated that in yet. So brand serializer, and while we're here, we'll do the product. Saves us a bit of time in the next step. So that's all the serializers brought in, ready to work. And so let's go back here, change brand to brand serializer, and there we go. That's pretty much all we need to do there. So that's the serializer and now the view set completed. So now let's go back into our view URLs even, and then let's just, I did it again, and let's go into the URLs and let's add a new set of URLs. So register, this is going to be called brand, and that's going to be views, and that's going to be the brand view set. And that's pretty much all that we need to do there, I think. So let's give this a go. Oh, actually, let's just run our documentation. Let's run our schema. Someone's going to tell me that I don't need to do that every time, but I'm going to do that every time. So run server, and now that's running. So let's go back into the schema. Remember, it's API/schema/docs. Let's go ahead and have a look. And there we go. So we have our brand endpoint. Now we don't have any data to try out just yet, but one can imagine that you can go into the admin. Now you know how to do that from the previous task and just add some data, and you can go ahead and try it out, execute it. It should return some data. Obviously, we don't have any data in here now. I already think that's a bad idea. We may as well just do it right. So let's go into the admin. May as well test this out, right? So, because we're going to need it for a product anyway. So let's call this brand one. Press save. So we can save data, which is good. So let's go back to where we were. So I'll keep pressing back. So I'm just going to run this out again, try it out again. And this time you can see that we return the brand. Okay. So we return string, name string. That's interesting. Oh, we didn't run it. Okay, so actually, we're not returning anything at all here in the response body. which is suggesting that there is potentially an issue here. So let's just refresh again. Okay, let's try this out again, just double check. So I've executed that and you can see that we're not returning anything. Okay, so let's just try this out manually. So it should be API brand, that's the endpoint that we generated. And you can see here, in actual fact, we're not returning any data. So it makes you wonder what the problem is. So let's open up a new tab. So I've opened up a new tab here. I'm going to go to admin. I know this is incredibly small maybe on your screen, do apologize. So let's have a look at brands. So we did add a brand. This is interesting. So just the brand name, that's pretty much all that we had here. So probably just some sort of typo that we've forgotten to change in our code base. So we just need to go through each step now. Seems like a logical way of working. So let's start off with our serializer. We just need to check the names. And you can see here, oh no, oh damn. Okay, so brand serializer, model is gonna be brand fields all. So clearly that looks absolutely fine. So we're bringing in brand, yep, our model brand. So we can go back to models if we need and just double check. Should just be the name, max length, understring name. Okay, everything looks okay there. So a serializer looks okay. So let's go into the views. That's the next step. So brand view set, a simple view set for viewing all brands. Yep. So we are making that query, the correct query here. And we are using the brand serializer and we are responding. Okay. So maybe what we can do here, let's go ahead and diagnose this. Let's go ahead and print. Okay, so what we're going to do is print the query set right here. So what should happen when we initiate this class? We should print out the details here. So let's just give this a go to see if this works. So let's go back into our previous tab here. We're just going to refresh. Oh, actually, for some reason, now it's working. That's pretty strange. So you can see now we're actually returning some data. I'm not entirely sure what happened there, or maybe what we did differently. Just double check in Visual Studio Code that you have autosave on. That's something that can cause a problem. So file autosave. So if you're wondering why something doesn't work, so many times I've helped students who've had errors and it's just because they haven't saved. So having autosave on is just something of a standard. I think that they should put it on by default. Right, so yeah, everything seems to be working fine. I'm not entirely sure what happened there, but you can see we're now returning the brand. So let's double check now the documentation. So from API, we're going to need to go to schema and docs. Let's test it out again. So this is going to be the brand. Let's try it out. Let's execute. And this time you can see that we're actually returning the brand. So everything is okay.